Okay, today I'm going to talk about how to rehair a violin bow. Okay, so I don't know, maybe the time is limited. So I don't know, I can, in one episode I can finish. Maybe we need another episode, whatever. So we just talk as fast as I could. Okay, all right. Okay, first thing that we talk about is rehair the bow. Well, first thing that we talk about is the common problems. How to take the, maybe you can take closer to the camera. So we how to remove this, you know, okay? So some people with appliance, you know, plug them out. I think maybe a little bit, it's a little bit dangerous. So the best way to remove it is just pull the hair out. Just a little at a time, you know, that's the best way to do it. So little bit by little, you know, little by little. So the hair is gonna come out like that. So this is just easy, it comes out, you know, comes out easily. Okay, so when you push out, this is easy, okay? Sometimes, sometimes we find that some cheaper bowl, or sometimes the bowl with the people used a long time, haven't really had, this one can be stuck with it. So I don't know, don't try to force it or whatever. So the best way, well, I don't know, recommend for expensive bowl, a cheaper bowl, you can go with a lighter, quickly move, you know, just heat them up, heat up here, you know, heat up there. But make sure don't stop, keep moving, don't burn it, just heat up, you know, heat up, you know, okay. Then with, you know, I made myself appliance with one part was thick, one part was very thin, like this, it goes inside to pull them out. Very easily. Okay, all right. So we take this out. Put it here. Okay, we take the hair out here. Okay, easy like that. Take it out. Okay, this one can be like this, gently comes off of mouth, easy. Okay, all right. So now another thing we want to talk about it, you know, when you rehair the bow, they have a different way to rehair the bow. Some people rehair the starting this side first, okay? And some people rehair with the start, use a rehair the frog first. Well, for my opinion, because somehow rehair the bow, sometimes you have to constantly adjust. Sometimes the hair is too short or hair is too long, you know, different weather, different temperature, different season, you know, sometimes drier weather, sometimes more wet, whatever. So the hair, the length can be, has to be constantly adjusted. For expensive bow, I don't want to, you know, open up, do it over again on the tips. It's very dangerous for the expensive bow. I'd rather set this first, and that's it. If it's too long, too short, I take it out, you know, change a few times. Use the frogs. It's a much better idea like that, okay? All right, so. Okay, now we talk about how to tie up the bow here. I noticed some people using the teeth holding one side of strings. Well, I think if they are young age, maybe it's okay. But if you become old, I don't know if you maybe your teeth could come off. You know, if your teeth are strong enough. So I made myself just put the device like this, put the hair like this. I think this is much easier, stronger way to holding the hair, you know, is much better like that way without just holding with the teeth, you know. Okay, so I don't know, you're young, it's okay, but when you get older, I think your teeth will come off. So this is probably the way to holding it like that. Okay, all right, now we put this the hair in there. Okay, I know some people doing differently. Some people put a little roll and burn it, so whatever. But which I like the best, which one put it I don't know, super glue, use the medium, you know. Don't use thin ones. Thin ones is very easy to go through. Maybe get all the part of the hair gets super, how can I say that, you know, maybe all the way go through. So making the whole thing stuck together. So just put a medium, you know, something like that. Put it with a toothpick. Put a little bit at a time, you know. Put a little bit of time. Okay. Yeah, so because that way you're not going to soak. So that's probably the safe. Then you can make them a little bit, make them like this, make them a little bit flat. So like that.
Okay, then put those in there.
Okay. All right, now we put a piece of wood in. Make sure this piece of wood should go easy. Never force them in there. Just a little bit of energy, you know. Put them in there. Which I like to add a little bit of glue to hold it. Just a little bit of glue holding it. This is very important, believe me. When the artists, you know, the violinists on the stage, you have very important concert or very important audition. If the hair comes off, that's really, really, I'm telling you, won't be happy, you know, be really mad at you. So make sure the bow has secured. I don't believe just put a piece of wood there, you're going to hold it. If you use too much energy without a good holding the wood, you might going to snap the tip, you know, they're very sensitive, very weak. So gently, just basically put in there. I will put a little bit of glue, you know, you're not gonna hurt. Just with toothpick, just a little bit. Okay. And here again, never use a hammer. And use something, piece of wood, something even larger than this piece of wood. So we go in easily, so this they can flat with the top, you see? Never get something like, I don't know, like something smaller. It might go through, even if you're gonna break the tip, you know? I mean, so something is larger, they're gonna stop on a flat. You make the flat, you see? Select like that. Okay, that's it. Okay? Then what do? You make sure this is comfortable. You know, you put them out a little bit. Gently pull the hair away. Now you can do like this. So in that way, the hair will stay flat, like this. Okay. All right, now we put it here. Okay, now we put it. Okay, here again, now we say how we comb the hair here, like that, okay? Okay, some people like to wet hair first. Before they start to mark it. But to me, that's not, maybe, I don't know, that's why it's okay, but to me, it's better make sure you mark it before the dry, because that's actually the length of the hair should be, you know, the correct length should be measured by when the hair was dry, not by the wet. So I will mark them first, okay? Before I make the hair wet. Okay, I mark it first, something like that, you know, okay, all right. Okay, now we make the hair wet, you know, you can, you know, whatever, you can soak the hair, whatever you want, okay? You can waste a piece of cloth, make them wet, so, okay, make sure. You have two fingers, hold it, make sure you push them evenly, okay? Yeah, well, you can, when you're holding this part, you can do whatever you want. You know, some people with a, I don't know, with a stick or with a clamp, something like that. You can pinch with hand, but all the pinch under, go under. Yeah, pinch in mark place, okay? So here again, we're gonna tighten it, you know? Yeah, I find this way tighter is much better than, is stronger than you're holding with your teeth, you know, something like that. So what do we do is, we have tied two knots. Halfway through, we tighten them up. What is it, why we need to tie two knots, okay? Because sometimes it's, if it's too short, we can take one out. So we need two knots there. If they're too long, we can add another one. So sometimes that's why we stop. Then we tie it again. The march. Yeah. Well, here again, you can rehear the first time a little bit longer than too short. You know, shortening it, it's only difficult. If it's too long, you can make them shorter. Okay. Okay, now we put some glue here. We'll here do it again. Hold them flat. You know, so that's make them flat. So this way, so it will go inside. Just correct. Okay, because of the time, so we have to do a little faster. We cannot have the video too long. I don't know, we can cover everything in there. So pretty much that's it. Okay. Here again, make sure you secure it well, but not over secure it. Just secure enough. Okay. Now we check the length of the hair. Because the winter is a little different. Winter, I think the moisture was kind of low. So usually the hair, your hair should be a little bit longer. I don't know, depends on the area, where you live, you know. So that's why we rehair that first. Because if here is too long, we do it again. It's not going to hurt the ball. But here is very dangerous. We can do it over again. Sometimes a very expensive blow. I just give, would have one chance to take it out. So I will take it one time, that's it. But here is much stronger. I can take it out, do it again, not too long, and I'm shorter, gradually find the way. I like it the way it is, you know. So just right, not too short, not too long. Okay, we're gonna check on this, right? Okay, now we put that's what I call the wedge wood inside here. Okay, sometimes you cannot just cut it, you know, just put it in there, you know, something like that. It's not gonna work. You have to make sure, can you look at it carefully? You have to make sure the corner has been removed a little bit. You know, remove a little bit of corner. So in that way, on both the corner has a little bit more extra hair. Still, they look nicer, and it all last longer to play. You know, we don't want to be everything the hair stuck in the middle, and it also not good for the bow. Sometimes the metal part, the ferrule part, can be, you know, expand some deformed because some people force it too much. So make sure you remove the corner. Yeah, remove the corner like that. You know, you can use this, like that, you know. So cannot be exactly just flat, because otherwise the hair all stuck in the middle, and the side of the less hair like this, okay? Okay, now the wedge wood inside. Here again, also we need to just hold very gently. You know, don't ever hammer it like this, you know, just put there basically. So you can see a little bit more hair here, evenly. I know some players say, hey, can you put more hair on the player's side? we can put a little bit, usually just in the corner, you know. Don't overdo it. You know, if you shift everything to the one side, when you play the body won't be balanced. You know what I mean? It looks funny. So I don't know, you know, don't go extreme. Yeah, just corner, make a little more hair on the corner. So here again, I mentioned when you put the weight in, you cut the corner out a little bit, put hair in the corner. So hair won't stuck in the middle. So this will be nicely, you know, it's not a harm for this one. It'll easily stay like that way. Okay? So we comb the hair a little bit. So make the hair, sure the hair all the way goes through easily. We starting to cross like that. That's bad hair. Because my player plays the ball, it feels funny like this. Okay? Alright, okay, now we talk about it. When you down some hair, you see, can hang loose a little bit. Especially, some balls are very difficult. Okay, I'm telling you, this ball is very, very weak, very soft, very hard to rehair. A lot of balls like that. I wish some balls, you know, stronger balls are easier. Some people like it, you know, very soft ball. Sometimes it's challenging. So, some people heat up the hair just in the alcohol flame, like this way. You know, like this with the heat up, like this. To me, a little bit of harm for the hair, maybe burn, you know, something like that. So I made it myself, you know, I had an alcohol lamp here. I use this, they call it a funnel, whatever. You know, this is for the drink the oil, you know, in the pan, like that. So I do like this. This alcohol lamp, you can buy it, you know, the coffee maker, called a Japanese coffee called a Hario, you know, you can buy this Amazon. So I put it on top. You can tell the heat, it goes through from here. So pretty much, I think it was kind of gentle enough, and it's doing a good job. So it's not gonna harm at all to the hair. So you don't see any burn because it's created by heat. So just created by the heat. So you can tell, right? You can tell which is gentle to heat up, you know. No burn at all, so that is one is to me is probably the best way to do it. You know, I would like to like go inside the fire, so you can tell the hair looks pretty good. You know, so a little bit on the corner has more hair, you can tell. So in that way, player like to do like that, but so no hair stand in the middle, so make sure it spread evenly. So just corner like that, you know, hair all straight. Something like that. Okay, for the rehair, with safety of the rehair is very, very important. If you rehair a bow, make sure you never touch people's bow. Means you never cut a piece of wood out, do some adjustment on the bow, because you might have balance issue here. So also people don't like it when you touch people. Just leave the bay. Some bow is difficult to rehair, but you will figure out how to do it. So never here again touch the people's ball. Sometimes if we have it too short, we do it again. You know, I see some people cut the people's stick, you know, the frog move forward. So you never do that. Never touch the people's ball. And then make sure how to secure the hair. It's very important for the player. You cannot just put a piece of wood, just put it in there. It's too risky. I don't know if an important concert here again. Some players are very, very aggressive, very, very strong. So they're gonna snap out. So I hope the next thing never happens to the player. Okay, because the time is limited, I can cover more, but I don't have enough time. So I'm kind of talking fast. So I hope we can take another video about it. Some other issues. Okay? Alright, thank you.